before the Reformation, most art was painted in Europe by Roman Catholic painters. And they tended to focus on religious emblems or images. And they tended to be idealized features. When Protestant painters emerged post-Reformation, some in Germany who worked very closely with Luther, and others particularly in the Netherlands, I think we could see at least two changes. The first is that in the life of the Dutch painters, particularly influenced by Calvin's worldview, they didn't paint an idealized world, but they started to paint the world as it was, a kind of broken beauty, as one art historian has called it. So they painted the fallenness and the frailty rather of human nature rather than in idealized form. One example would be Rembrandt's painting of his mother reading the scriptures. Now, when he painted his mother, she was very old, and he was a master of portraiture. He paints the wrinkles on her face. He paints the skin on her fingers, which you can see is aged and weakened. So he paints the broken beauty of his mother, whose frailty is evident to all. But she's reading the scriptures, and Rembrandt was a master of visual light. And the light in the picture sheds on the scriptures and from the scriptures to the face of Rembrandt's mother. So you can see the notion of her being illuminated in all her brokenness as she reads the text of scripture. So this notion of broken beauty is there in the lives of some of these painters influenced by the Reformation. The second is, particularly in the lives of the Dutch painters, that they started to paint everyday scenes, indicating that Christ was the Lord of all creation, which was to be appreciated. Most Roman Catholic painters before the Reformation had painted religious scenes. What the Dutch painters started to do was paint landscapes, even utensils in the kitchen, or everyday scenes. And that's because, or portraits, and that's because they were trying to demonstrate that God was the Lord of all creation. To quote Abraham Kuyper, one of the great Dutch political thinkers and Christian ministers who was influenced by Calvin's theology, there's not one centimeter of human existence to which Christ, who is Lord of all, does not point and say, "That is mine." So what the Dutch painter started to show was really the lordship of Christ over the whole of creation. I suppose the third dimension, intriguingly, is that before the Reformation, there were very few paintings of the Resurrection. And in a lot of the paintings of Roman Catholic painters before the Reformation, there was a very emphasis on the cross and the death of Christ, but very few paintings of the Reformation, of the Resurrection. And it's in the work of many of the Protestant painters after the Reformation that you see much more painting which tries to portray the impact of the resurrection of Jesus Christ, both in the work of some of the German painters who were close to Luther and in some of the Dutch painters like Rembrandt. So they still painted the cross, but they also painted the resurrection as a symbol of the hope that comes from the gospel.